In much of the developing world, pollution is a major problem with serious consequences for health and well-being. Yet few countries have invested in the infrastructure to provide their citizens with credible pollution information. What are the benefits of doing so? Can such programs mitigate pollution's negative effects? This paper explores these questions by evaluating a landmark program in China. Throughout the 2000s, China's daily average concentration of fine particulate matter was estimated to be 5 times above WHO guidelines, but monitoring was limited and severe air pollution was often confused with heavy fog. Amid rising concern over the lack of transparency, the government made a dramatic change in 2013 and launched a nationwide program with 2 major provisions. The installation of a comprehensive network of air quality monitors that covered an estimated 98% of the country's population, and an information dissemination system in which all monitoring data were automatically broadcast to the general public in real time. To assess the program's impact on pollution awareness, consumption decisions, and health outcomes, the authors leveraged its staggered rollout, which was implemented in 3 waves over the course of 2 years. Cities were assigned to waves based on administrative hierarchies determined long before the monitoring program, and preliminary checks show there is no correlation between the rollout schedule and day-to-day variation in local pollution levels. There were also no other programs or regulations following a similar rollout schedule during the period in question. To start, these figures show the monitoring program substantially increased public access to pollution information. The left panel shows that the frequency with which air pollution-related articles were published in the government's official newspaper rose from less than once per week to almost daily after the program's start, and there is a sharp increase in local pollution coverage as individual cities enter the program. There is also a surge in mobile phone apps providing real-time updates on air quality, and the improved access to information is reflected in increased public awareness. At the national level, there is a 25-fold increase in internet searches using the word smog, and there is a strong seasonal pattern with the highest values during the winter when pollution is more severe. There is also a change in public opinion toward environmental issues. Data from a nationally representative survey show that respondents had increased concerns about environmental issues after the program began, while showing no change in concern for other social and economic issues. Tellingly, this increase is driven by respondents living in cities with high levels of pollution. Pre-monitoring, there is no correlation between levels of environmental concern and local pollution, but these become strongly positively correlated after the program begins. What does greater access to information achieve? Given the sharp change in public awareness, do individuals take steps to reduce the negative effects of pollution? Using the universe of credit card and debit card transactions that occurred at physical stores in China from 2011 to 2016, the authors analyzed the program's effect on the shopping pollution gradient. This is the extent to which outdoor shopping trips vary with weekly fluctuations in ambient pollution. A negative value implies avoidance, namely, that individuals adjust their behavior to reduce their time outside when pollution is worse. This figure shows estimates for the causal effect of the program on the shopping pollution gradient in each quarter. The estimated effect is statistically indistinguishable from zero in the pre-period, but immediately becomes negative after the program starts. The gradient is 1.4 percentage points more negative in the post-period, and this increase in avoidance behavior is concentrated in consumption categories that are relatively easy to defer, such as supermarket shopping and restaurant dining. As further evidence of behavioral change, the monitoring program substantially intensified defensive spending. Within 1 year of program implementation in a city, purchases of air purifiers almost doubled and became highly correlated with contemporaneous local pollution levels. These behavioral changes have the potential to mitigate the negative health effects of severe pollution, and to that end, this figure shows the program's estimated effect on the mortality pollution gradient. There is a 1.3 to 2.3 percentage point reduction in the gradient after monitoring began, indicating that pollution became less deadly. The effect is concentrated among individuals aged 60 and above, and is more pronounced for deaths due to cardiovascular and respiratory causes. Thus, this paper shows that China's policy to monitor and disclose pollution information led to changes in information access and public awareness that triggered a cascade of behavioral changes and improved health outcomes. Estimates for the age-adjusted value of a statistical life and the healthcare costs of air pollution imply that the program generated annual mortality and morbidity benefits of at least 93 billion, which is a full order of magnitude greater than its annual cost of 9.5 billion. This speaks to the cost-effectiveness of information monitoring and disclosure, and serves as an important example for other developing countries facing severe environmental challenges. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on behavioral responses to pollution exposure, the role of pollution information, and how information shapes consumer choices more broadly.